Pedro Arandia, I'm from Argentina. I'm an artist almost since I remember a bit, because as soon as I was a kid, basically what happened is I found like I could draw very well, like when I was in kindergarten or even really early stage. I got a, you know, basically that's where I started doing drawings and
the painting,
you know, like painting.
They start from a book. I just brought a book about Art Nouveau. Actually, it was Art Deco. Just without much technique, just put the colors and do it totally different than the outside, because inside is a bit more like basic and outside is a bit more technical and more well painted, you know what I mean? Like the center is pretty, I don't know, it's just, it's really like.
I like this painting, unfortunately it's already sold, but yeah, I like to do homage to the people I feel admiration. Again, the orchestra's in the top, a lot of colors, a bit crazy. This is already sold, but I have to finish his face and just touch up some little things. But yeah, well, it will be a pleasure that some people have this painting in their home. You know, I think that's the mission of every artist. You know, you just want to give your
tango. I was more into rock and roll. I used to I used to have long hair and go to rock and roll places. You know, as a teenager. Eventually, I just met this Italian woman from Netherlands, a blonde, blue-eyed woman, really beautiful, really, really nice-looking woman. We started going out, and one time she went to a tango place, and she said, "I'm going to a tango place." I said, "Okay, see you later." She came back, she was really stressed, a bit red-faced, and a bit really stressed. And I said, "What's going on? What happened at that place?" And she said, "Oh, it was a lot of old, sleazy guys trying to touch me, and it was, you know, a bit, you know, unequal, or I don't know what the word was, just not really nice." And I was like, "Oosh," I was like that. But she said to me, "You should be dancing tango, because if you dance in tango, I would love to dance with you, and other people would love to dance with you." And that was the beginning of, like, what happened is I just said to her, "Well, look, I promise I will learn tango for you." And anyway, the relation kaput, finished immediately when she left the country. But I just keep going with the promise. As soon as she left, I just went. Dancing even underground, even like in basements or in places very dodgy, and the tango was still underground somewhere there in Buenos Aires, you know. And after the tourists from Germany, from other countries, they love the dancing and they start doing the same, copy and imitate it and do it in other countries. The thing is, for that reason, you will realize how important are the dancers, because when tango was almost dead, the dancers are the ones keep alive the dandy.
Duomo. The name of the milonga is Bailongo. That was my first tango place here in Perth, and starting in 2000, I think, so 1999-2000. And that's the reason why in the top say Bailongo, because that mean in Argentinian slang, that mean tango, like a tango dance hall or whatever you want to call, like a dance hall, a tango dance hall. Basically what I did is, because we like to have musicians, and sometimes it's hard to for the budget to have musicians, because you know when you do this kind of events or this kind of art, it's quite difficult. Yeah, it's just a difficult business. But anyway, just I decided to do an orchestra, and this guy is very famous. His name is Aníbal Troilo. For many people in Argentina and around the world, he considered the one, the fat one there, the number one.
But the painting is not really a painting. It's not a traditional painting, because it's a mixed technique. Basically it's a piece of wood. And what happened? I decided to do again another homage to Aníbal Troilo, the famous bandoneon player, one of my heroes. Basically, I did the technique of printmaker, like woodcut, in the beginning, and after I did all the relief here, with the knife for the like woodcut, and eventually after I decided to do it more realistic, to painting in the top. And it just worked really well, and this is all, again is one of my favorite works, because all the artwork in his face, and it's just such a good
tango
work. I really like
the tango. Right, the tango what is the bigger one, milonga what is the African influence, have a lot of African influence, and the waltz what is a bit like the European waltz, the Viennese waltz from Austria, but in a tango version. The milonga is very nice and happy. It's very, very colorful. Have a lot of rhythm, and it really helps to be happy, I suppose, because the background is African. What happened is in the old days in Argentina, it was African people too, as many countries, as slaves or whatever. They used to live apart from the other immigrants, and they used to have their own ghettos. Do circles with drums and play the drums and dance there. What the tango people did, where it was more Italian, Spanish, German, more European, they are used to listen the blacks, and they are used to do jokes, yeah, even jokes and do fun about them. But for any reason, they are listening the drums, and eventually they start incorporating the drums into the tango, and that's how we born the milonga. And everybody knows in Argentina that milonga is very African, because the rhythm is 1-2-1-2.
cosa se puso mal, no hay más gaucho, más orquímus y más feliz que aquella verdad. Tango negro, los tambores no suenan más, los reyes están de luto, ya nadie lo va a clavar.
Photographer take this picture in black and white from me, and I like the picture, and from the black and white picture I put color to, and I did this portrait. It's very figurative, the face is a bit ambivalent. I reckon I still could touch a bit to some things, but I'm pretty happy. It's quite a good technical, like quite nice, and I
reckon
this one is one of my best paintings.
This painting is from an article, an interview the Sunday Times did about myself in 2001. I did some 4 shows in His Majesty's Theatre, and the show went sold out. The Sunday Times just sent a journalist and a photographer, and they did a really big interview and a big article, like 3 pages. When I saw the pictures in the newspaper, in the Sunday Times, I like this one, and this is my ex-partner, Laura, and myself. We are just doing a rehearsal in King Street Art Studios.
It's a very dramatic, dance form, very, very, very dramatic music. You have to have some pain in your soul, like, for understand the music. That means, like, if you're a kid, a happy kid, and you go to the pub and everything is fun, you might not understand that point. And soon I got that breakdown with the first important girlfriend in my life. I think that's the moment where I believe I understand tango, because tango talk a lot about that. Tango talk a lot about the moment between a couple is broken up. And that's when I started listening to the lyrics, and when I understand what is about tango. A lot of the part of the tango is about sentimental, about women, and about relationships, problems. And eventually, that was the moment where I started dancing, and where I understand the lyrics, the music, and all the drama behind tango. That's the beginning of the tango.
Thank you.
the eye for obvious reasons. This painting is a tribute, an homage to a dance company called Tango por Dos, again from Miguel Ángel Soto and Milena Plebs. A lot of these dancers are in the background, are my friends. I'm very identified with the technique of the dance. And it's again that homage, the eye coming from Escher print. Escher is a very good printmaker from 1920s to 1930s. Well, I really like this painting. I did under the guidance of a really good teacher in the 4 years of university. He really loved it too, and yeah, I'm really happy with this painting.
Anyway, the thing is, as soon as I start dancing tango, I start reading about all these artists, biographies, histories, books about the lyrics, about the musicians, the composers, a lot of things. Every day I used to read a new book, and I read so much. Plus I start dancing, I start watching the legends live, you know, when I used to go to dance, because when I start dancing in 91, still was a few legends like Osvaldo Pugliese alive and stuff, guys like that. Like I've been in the movie of Osvaldo Pugliese, I feel like about that too. Stuff like that, you know. Basically what happened is when you listen to music, you listen to the songs that compose, you start having so much respect. Later on, when I have more skills as an artist, a plastic artist, I start doing sculptures, paintings about kind of homage to these great artists. Because they are truly, for the Argentinian culture, especially for the tango culture, they are really truly the masters, you know. Like,
Enzo Bernini is a very famous artist from 1960s, no, 1600 anyway. In the period after the Renaissance, like after Michelangelo, Gian Lorenzo Bernini was probably one of the best. He did the Vaticano inside, he did all the decoration inside and all the artworks and the sculptures. Such a great artist. I was studying him, and he used to work with Metamorphosis. And obviously I feel inspiration about that. This is a famous bandoneon player. For many people is the number one in the world and in the history. And for that reason, because he was such a big artist and a bandoneon player 100%, from his head and his suit or whatever you call it, his tuxedo, I did his back. And in his back, how you can see, I put his bandoneon. That means like his back is a bandoneon. And yeah, this is 100% original. That's one of probably the most creative and original ideas I ever had. And I really like this sculpture. And I'm pretty sure that I'm a good tango fan and will love this picture, this sculpture. And yeah, I plan to do more sculptures and more homage to big artists like Astor Piazzolla